Considering the fact that Republicans are refusing to do anything about George Santos, the liar, being not only seated in Congress, but also on his way to getting cushy committee assignments, Democrats have decided to take the matter into their own hands, and late last week, they introduced the SANTOS Act. SANTOS, of course, S-A-N-T-O-S, stands for Stopping Another Non-Truthful Office Seeker Act. Named after, of course, George Santos, which I think is absolutely hilarious. But honestly, it's right. It is the right thing to do. And what this legislation says is that anybody that lies to voter about their background, about who they really are, could face $100,000 in criminal penalties or 1 year in prison, or hopefully both. Now, here is a list of things that George Santos has lied about that we know of so far. This is from HuffPost. He lied about where he went to high school, graduating from college, being a star volleyball player at a college he never attended, running a real estate empire, having a high-profile career on Wall Street, running a charity that saved thousands of dogs, being a biracial descendant of Ukrainian Jews whose grandparents survived the Holocaust. He's also claimed that his mother was a finance executive who died as a result of the 9/11 attacks, and that four of his employees died in the 2016 Pulse nightclub shooting. However, no evidence backs up either of those claims. So, he's been not exactly forthright, you know, if you know what I mean. And of course, that is unfair to the voters. He presented himself as one thing that was a complete fabrication, and it turns out he is something else. That is not what they voted for. And I know Kevin McCarthy is out there saying, like, well, it's up to the voters to decide. The voters were deceived. They were presented one thing only to find out that the thing they actually voted for doesn't really exist and instead is another thing. And as this act points out, there's no remedy for that. Like, you can go to voters right now, lie your ass off, tell them that, oh my God, hey, I've been to outer space 5 times. It's beautiful. It's magnificent. I saved the rocket ship on the way down. The media covered it up, you know, because the Pentagon, they didn't want people to know how bad it was. But I tell you, I was there. And voters say, oh my God, we got this hero astronaut. No, it's not. It's just some yahoo from the sticks that thought, hey, I could pull one over just like George Santos. And you couldn't do anything about it. This act would stop that. It has zero chance of passing the Republican-controlled House for very obvious reasons. But eventually, when Democrats take over, which will happen, you know, maybe in 2 years, maybe 4, maybe 6, who knows, this is a piece of legislation that needs to come back. This is something that needs to be kept on that back burner so that it can be passed, so that voters do not get screwed over again. This shouldn't even be a partisan thing. This isn't left or right. It's about making sure that the voters, the constituents, the people of this country do not get screwed over by a charlatan like George Santos ever again. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.